just see if Marnie's watching, because Marnie, is that you? This story is about my friend Marnie and I. Welcome out. No, this is, yes, but let's just ask her.
I was just texting you back.
Okay, so you're watching?
I'm watching, yes.
All right.
And I'm going into lunch in 2 seconds, but I happened to see someone said my coming out story, so I'm like, I
can't believe you're going into lunch. You can fact check my story.
Fine, then you know what? I'm going to be still watching with us.
Okay, perfect. All right.
All right, so I'll be trying to listen.
All right, you're on live. Okay, bye. So about a few weeks before, Marnie just said 1996, a few weeks before that, I watched an episode of a show called The Golden Girls. And on The Golden Girls, it was an episode where one of Blanche Devereaux's friend comes to visit the girls and stays at the house, and she's their age, and she develops, over the course of the episode, some semblance of an attraction to Rose. And we don't really fully know this, but we know that she's amused by and entertained by and thoroughly pleased by Rose. So the crux of the episode, at the apex, if you will, Rose is sitting on a bed. Rose has no idea what's happening. Rose Nyland, she doesn't know what's going on. She's sitting on a bed, and Blanche's friend is sitting next to her. And Blanche's friend looks at her and says a compliment. And Rose says, ah, she's another compliment. And Rose is like, ah, doesn't get it. She's a third compliment, ah. And finally, the friend says, Rose, I'm very intrigued by you. Rose gets it. It was the word intrigue that got Rose to understand that she was being hit on by this woman, and all the suddenly turned to, oh, now I understand what's happening. So as a young, impressionable 20-something, I took the word intrigue to mean that's how you hit on a woman. What did I know? I didn't know any different. I just thought that when you tell someone you're intrigued by them, it means you're hitting on them based upon an episode of The Golden Girls in about 1997 or 98. So now fast forward, my best friend is a girl by the name of Marnie. She's on the show a lot. She always calls in. She was the first friend I met when I moved to the United States. Marnie went to a school like a couple hours away from me. We would visit each other. After school, she worked in Manhattan. I worked in Philadelphia and then Rochester. Every year we go away together. Every year for the last 20 years, we've taken like a little vacation together. She's now married with two kids. She lives in Florida. And I have my two kids, and I am up here in New York. We still manage to find like 2 or 3 days or 4 days where we can go away. So this was, we were, I don't know, maybe 22, 23 years old, and we decided we were going to Club Med in Turks and Caicos. It was one of our normal vacations. We were going away for a week. Neither of us were dating anyone at the time. So we go away, and and we're in Turks and Caicos, and we're very similar. We've always done this. We get up in the morning. I train her. I've always trained her. We work out, come back to the room, change into bathing suits, go eat, and we're at the pool all day. Once we work out, and that's it. That was what we always did. So on this one particular day, day two of our 6 or 7 day stay at Club Med in Turks and Caicos, we worked out, we came back, we changed. On the way to the pool, the Club Med offers an activity called trapeze, literally a trapeze. And Connor, if you want to write down like questions or whatever, because I'm not going to stop. I'm just going to plow through the story. So I was like, Marty, let's just try this. It kind of looks cool. You climb up, you swing, you hang, you do flips. Like, that's right up my alley. She's like, but we have the pool thing. I said, Marn, let's do it. Now, Marty and I can convince each other to do anything. Marty could be like, come on, let's get weaves put in our hair. And I'd be like, all right, if you think so. And I'd be like, Marty, let's get a nose pierce. She'll be like, okay, if you think so. Like, we are so highly impressionable, and we're so highly like convinced that we can convince each other to do anything. I can tell you some very funny stories. So Marty and I stop off at this trapeze place, and there's a guy that's on the ground, and he is organizing and giving people like very brief instructions, and then there's a woman up top who's helping like latch people on and go through the thing. So we did the thing on the bottom, and then I go to climb up, and there's this woman, and she says, hi, my name's Janine. What's your name? And I was like, hi, it's Jenna. She's like, hey. And she's very close to me, and she's latching this thing on. And I was like, all I could think to myself was, be friends with her. What does that even mean? I want to be friends with her. I just met her. Well, that lasted for 2 seconds. It was a fleeting thought, and off I went. Hanging on this bar, swinging across, landing, and Marnie's like, all right, let's go to the pool. I said, can we do it one more time? She goes, one more time? I go, yeah, just one more time. She goes, I don't know if I really want to. I'm like, awesome, you stay here, wait for me. I'm going to run up, do it one more time, and then we'll go to the pool. She says, fine. You know, I told you, I could have said, let's get a belly ring. She would have been like, okay. So I climb up. There's Janine again. She said, hi. I said, hi. And she's like, let me let you in. And I wanted the moment to last longer. I don't know why, but I did. So I said, how long have you been doing this? Is this what you do? Where are you from? I must have asked 15 questions. She's like, I'm from Canada. I wanted to take 6 months off to just come down here and work. And that's it. And I was like, cool, awesome. She's like, all right, well, she's like, there's a line, so we got to get you up. And I was like, oh my gosh, you're right. She hooks me up. She's really close to me. And I was like, thinking to myself, I want to be her friend. Again, don't know what it means. Had no interest in women, dated men, dating men, was going to date men. But for some reason, I wanted to be Janine's friend. Did the trapeze again, came down, met up with Marnie. We went to the pool the whole day. Never said anything else, dropped it. Next morning, we work out, come back to the room, change, shower, on our way to breakfast. I said, Mark, can we stop at the trapeze one more time? She goes, again with the trapeze? I go, I don't know, I just kind of like it. He's like, okay. We get to the trapeze, and this time Janine was on the ground, and the guy was up top. So I asked a couple questions on the ground, went up top, did the trapeze. When I really like someone, I want to get as good as I possibly can at anything. I was so good at trapeze. This went on for about 3 days. I was hanging, I was literally swinging. I had my knees curled over and I was swinging by my knees. So I was hung, you know, like upside down, swinging. And then I went and grabbed the guy's hands and I let go of my knees and swung down. That's not a beginner move. That's like a medium move. It's certainly not an advanced move, but that's someone who's been doing trapeze for a little while. You're not just swinging upside down and doing things. My point was I got really good at it because I really enjoyed it and wanted to get really good at it. What is it, Connor?
Blanche.
His name is Blanche Devereaux. Said
Blanche and Rose, the dream team. Original dream team.
And that's what I'm talking about. Okay, so I did this for 3 straight days where every free moment I had, I was over a trapeze. So the fourth day we're there, I wake up in the morning. Marnie and I are, you know, we had 2 separate little twin beds or whatever it is. It's early in the morning, and I said, hey, Marnie, and she said, yeah, and I said, there's no part, this is 100% what I said, exactly the way I said it. I said, hey, Marnie, she said, yeah, I said, what if I'm gay? Without even skipping a beat, Marnie said, okay, awesome. I said, what? She said, that's awesome, good for you. I go, what? No, do you want to know why? Or is that okay? Or what do you mean that's awesome? She goes, who cares? She goes, I love you. I am not surprised. I go, you're not? She goes, no. I said, well, because I find myself thinking about that girl from Trapeze. She goes, I hope so, because otherwise I was afraid you were going to go back to New York and become a freaking trapeze artist because we've spent an obscene amount of time at the trapeze place this week. And she said, it's okay. I go, no, Marnie, I think I like this woman. She goes, great. I said, well, what do I do about it? And she goes, I don't know. Maybe you should tell her. I go, no, I'm never gonna tell her. She goes, okay, then don't worry about her. Just, it's okay if you're gay. I was like, all right, okay. Okay, I guess I'm gay. That's exactly what happened. So I said, okay. So obviously we went back to trapeze. And in my head, this woman, Janine, knew exactly who I was and was almost looking forward to seeing me every day. In my head. On the fifth night, it was a Friday night, it was a big bonfire. And there was a big bonfire on the beach and everyone is gathered around. And I just mentioned at the time that Marnie was hooking up with the chef down there. We both were like having her. That's what Club Med is. You go down, you meet people, you're hooking up. She's listening right now. I'm sure she's dying. So, so she's with the chef, I won't, well, let's call, I'll make up a name. We'll call him Joshua. So she is basically like, we're all, it's me and it's Marty and it's Joshua. We're all sitting there. And in walks Janine. In, we're at the beach. Janine walks over. So I said, Marty, there's Janine. She goes, and so Joshua goes, you have to go tell her. I go, what am I going to tell her? He goes, it doesn't matter. Just tell her you like her. Just tell her. You'll forever kill yourself and kick yourself if you don't. So I said, Marty, because Marty is like my shaman, my like guru, my everything. I said, what do I do? She goes, look, leave it all down here. You know, just go. Just do it. Just go. Don't think. Just do. I said, okay. So I had just gotten a job offer in Philadelphia. At the time, I was living in Rochester, New York. I got a job offer in Philadelphia. I was leaving Rochester. It's a new chapter in my life about to happen. I was making it to the number four market in the country. I was finally finding some success with my career. It was time for me to work on my personal life. I said, okay, I'm going to do it. She said, well, what are you going to say? I said, I don't know, but I'm going to tell her. I'm going to say something. I was shitting bricks. You know that expression? Because that's exactly what it felt like was happening. I was so nervous. I'll never forget it, but it was the most amazing nervousness I've ever felt in my life. It was the most beautiful anxiety I have ever experienced. To be so nervous and yet to plow through is one of the most exciting, exhilarating feelings in the world. You know how I always say life isn't a dress rehearsal, this isn't dress rehearsal, this is the main performance? This was it. I was walking out on stage. There was not going to be a second or a third or a fourth chance at this. This was the one chance I had. And I was terrified. I didn't know what I was gonna say. I didn't know how I was gonna say it. And I certainly didn't know what she was gonna say in return. Nor did I know, was I gonna kiss her? Was I gonna shake her hand? Was I gonna give her a high five? I don't even know. So I get up and my stomach is crunching and turning and pulling. And I'm so scared. And I'm like, you know, when there's two ways you sweat. You sweat a little bit here and in the back of your neck when you're about to throw up, right? And you sweat a little bit here in the back of your neck when you're about to do something amazing. And sometimes your body doesn't know which is which. Only your head and your heart know. So my head and my heart were like, hey, body, she's not going to throw up. She's just going to do something insane right now. So I walked to her. And as I'm walking over, I'm thinking, I swear I said this. I go, are these the last 30 seconds of my being a straight person? Is this the last time in my life I'm a straight person? Like in 30 seconds, is it all gonna be over? I don't know. I also don't know what's about to happen. So I walk right up to her, and in my mind, I was gonna say Janine, and she was gonna say, hey, Jenna, what's up? I walk over to her and I say, I'm nervous telling the story. I said, hey, Janine. I was wearing a sundress, and I have this crazy curly hair, and I didn't want to be fiddling with my hair, so I pulled it all back. I might have pulled a little too tight. I said, hey, Janine, and she looked up, and she said, she was with a group of people. She said, yeah. I said, can I talk to you for a second? And she said, okay. I figured out pretty quickly that she had no idea who I was. I thought she knew me from coming every day, but everyone came every day to see her at the trapeze. I thought for sure she was gay and that she knew what was going to happen and what was coming down the pike, even though I didn't. So I called her over and we were standing with the fire was at our backdrop. So it was the fire and then we were standing sort of in front of it. And then Marty and Joshua were sort of like 20 or 30 meters away. Meters, whatever it was, yards away. And I said, so I want to tell you something. And my hands are sweaty and I'm scared and I'm looking right at her and I remember thinking, she's so beautiful. She's really pretty. This is going to be, I'm just going to speak from the heart. I'm going to just, whatever comes out of my mouth is, I'm just going to own it, right? I'm just going to own this. Like whatever happens in the next 2 minutes, it's mine. I said, I'm sure you notice I've been coming to trapeze a lot. I don't even like trapeze. Everything I'm telling you in this story is exactly how it happened. And it's going to sound ridiculous because that's the way I work. There's a little bit of ridiculousness in everything that I do. I said, I don't even like trapeze. I've never been to a trapeze. I don't want to do trapeze. I have a great job in Rochester and I just got this great, great job in Philadelphia and it's going to pay me a lot of money and I'm going to be a sportscaster. And the little, the well-dressed, smart girl, Jenna, on my shoulder said, shut the hell up to the little stupid devil who was telling her about this great job I got in Philadelphia. And this little devil, Jenna, was like, no, we should tell her how much money we're going to make at this new job because that's going to impress her. And this little Jenna was like, that's literally the last thing you want to be saying right now. Just tell her how you feel. So this Jenna went out for a split second. I got off of the Philadelphia thing when I saw that she was not reacting to it whatsoever. So I said, so anyway, there's a lot going on in my successful career world, and I just I'm down here as a little break, and I met you, and I saw you, and I keep coming back to Trapeze every day because there's something I have to tell you. I was getting nothing back in return, and when I get nothing back from someone, it's hard for me to keep going, which is odd because I've spent 20 years of my life talking to a television camera where you get nothing back, but I continue to emote, and I continue to explain, and I continue to feel, and I continue to talk. It's why I always want your attention, Connor. It makes me feel like I'm talking to someone.
I understand.
So I said to her, I keep coming back every day because I like seeing you, but more than that, there's something I have to tell you, and I'm not sure how to say it, and I've never said this to anyone else before, and I don't know if I'll ever say it again, but I'm going to say it now because I said this. I said, because I'm going to own the moment, and if the moment crashes, at least I'll know that I went down the way I wanted to go down. So here goes. I'm just going to say it, and I'm building this up, and I'm losing my breath, and I'm super excited, and I'm so nervous, and Marnie's watching, and the bonfire, and the water, and the waves, and everything, and I look her right in the eyes, and I said, Janine, I'm very intrigued by you. Now remember, in my mind, I assumed that intrigued meant I have a lesbian crush on you. I have a female crush on you. Girl to girl, I'm attracted to you. Because of that stupid episode from the Golden Girls, I thought that's what everybody says when they're hitting on another woman. I said, Janine, I'm very intrigued by you. Nothing. Nothing. She was just staring at me. So I said, well, if I'm going this far, I may as well go all the way. So I said, so embarrassing. I said, so in addition to being intrigued by you, I want to, and this is where I really lost it. I said, I want to walk down the beach with you. I want to hold your hand. I want to like look at you. I didn't even know what I was doing. I was now spiraling out of control. At this point, it was almost as I had a director going, stretch, because you're making a complete fool out of yourself. You may as well, if you're going to go down in flames, you may as well take everybody else with you. That's what was happening. So I said, this is the worst. I said, I want to walk down the beach with you. I want to hold your hand. And I think I want to kiss you. But mainly, I'm really intrigued by you. I spoke for about 5 straight minutes. When I was done, I knew at some point I had to stop talking. Sometimes I want to cover every uncomfortable moment with words, and oftentimes it's better to do it without the words. So I was talking and talking, and when I hit the part about wanting to kiss her on the beach, and then I brought it back to I'm very intrigued by you, I stopped. I looked at her, and part of me thought she was going to take my hand and just start walking down the beach with me. I mean, that was the moment was ripe for that. It was a soap opera. There was like music in the background. Like that's what was supposed to happen. And I was standing there in front of this woman who I honestly just sold my soul to. And Janine looked me right in the eyes. And I swear I thought she was going to take my hand or kiss me. And she said, thank you. And she walked away. Walked away. Didn't turn around, didn't look back, certainly didn't take my hand. She said thank you, and she walked away. And then what was anxiety hardened into a lump that then came up and hung out right here. I will never, ever, ever forget what it tasted like to have to swallow the lump in my throat, turn around with the proverbial tail between my legs, and walk back to Marnie and Joshua. It was about 20 steps, and in those 20 steps, I remember thinking, life is so funny. Like, life just hoisted me as high as I possibly could go, and life just dragged me as low as I could possibly go, all in a span of 5 minutes. And as upset as I was, and I was devastated, I'm gonna tell you about how devastated I was in a second, I said to myself, boy, this life of mine, it's gonna be one hell of a ride. If I can let myself get that high and let myself get this low, this is gonna be one hell of a ride. So strap in and enjoy it. And that moment quickly left, and I walked back to Marty and Joshua without them saying one word. I said, what the fuck is the deal with the word intriguing? What am I missing with that word? And Joshua said, what? He was older. Marty didn't know any better. Marty and I are idiots. Marty said, yeah, that's the lesbian word. You tell people you're intrigued. It's from Golden Girls. I go, yeah. Joshua goes, what are you idiots talking about? That doesn't mean anything. It's nothing to do. There's no lesbian connotation. I said, no. He's like, that's what you went with? You went with intriguing? All the words and you went intriguing? I said, yeah, that's what the woman used to hit on Rose Nyland. He goes, from the Golden Girls? I go, yeah. He goes, let me see if I understand this. You went with a line from the Golden Girls as your first moment to hit on someone. I said, yeah, that's what I did. He said, boy, you are something else, aren't you? I said, I guess I am. Now, let me tell you how the next 24 hours went. I left the next day. Next day I was leaving. That night, my right eye started itching a ton. I thought I was too close to the embers and the fire, and I got something in my eye. I scratched it and scratched it and rubbed it and rubbed it. By the time I woke up in the morning, it was sealed shut. The left eye was just about sealed. I had gotten pink eye in both eyes. So now I got pink eye in both eyes. I'm devastated. I'm in tears. Marnie had to leave Joshua. She was crying hysterically. So I'm wearing glasses and couldn't see anything. Marty's taking my hand. I had the worst glasses. You know, you buy them at an airport. Marty's holding my hand. We have a picture, and I'm going to share this picture of Marnie holding my hand and pulling me, and I didn't know where I was going because I couldn't see anything. There was nothing. We left too early for them to me to go to the infirmary for them to give me drops. They were sealed shut by the time I got to the airport. We both flew back to JFK. Then I had to get on another plane to go up to Rochester, New York, where I lived. We had to have someone from airport security take me in a wheelchair to get to the, because I couldn't see anything. So I'm walking, she's pulling me. I'm like, it's so sad, it's so awful, couldn't see anything. Marty is pulling me, she's devastated, she's crying. The two of us get on this plane hysterically crying. I didn't know what was going on. I got to Rochester, I got off the plane, they took me immediately to one of these like urgent care places where they finally put stuff in my eye. It wasn't until 24 hours after that I finally called Marty and I said, you know what? I don't think I'm gay. I think that was just something I went through. And she goes, I guess you're not. She goes, but I'm kind of glad you went through it. I go, I don't feel that way right now. Maybe one day I'll look back on the story and laugh, which I'm doing right now. And so guess what I did? I went right back in the closet for 10 more years. No, it wasn't 10 years. It was about 6 years. Dated guys, had fun, all of it. Never thought about it again. Except that Janine, the word Janine meant so much to me. It meant like feeling something I never felt. It meant experiencing something I never experienced. It meant doing something I never did. It meant saying something I've never said. It had this like exhilarating connotation to me. And it still does to this day. And anytime I meet someone named Janine, I have to smile a little bit. Anyway, 6 years go by until I was mature enough at age 29 to know that, yeah, there was something there, and it wasn't just a fleeting moment or an obsession with trapeze, that I really, truly, truly felt something. And I wonder how different my life would be today if Janine had said yes that night on the beach. You know, like I would have been dating someone when I met Steph. Maybe I don't have the kids I have. Maybe I would have started earlier. Maybe I would have started later. Like, sliding doors. Like, we meet who we're supposed to meet, when we're supposed to meet them. So anytime someone comes in your life and you're not really sure why, know that there is a reason why. So that's my story. And it's a crazy story, and I don't tell it often. But when I do tell it, it really brings me back to doing something that terrifies me, and how much you're supposed to embrace those rare, rare moments. Because life doesn't always give you an opportunity to do something absolutely terrifying. But when life does, embrace it. Really, embrace it. It is single-handedly the biggest learning experience you will ever have in your entire life. There's no better way to learn than doing something you're absolutely terrified of doing it, but doing it anyway. Whether you succeed or fail, if you do it, you take yourself out of its comfort zone and you grow. And those are the best moments of your life, hands down. Woo! The end. Well, let me read some questions here real quick. Do you ever wonder if Janine was gay? I was positive Janine was gay.
Maybe she just wasn't ready to come out.
Maybe not. Rosemary Quinlan invited followers again. Thank you, Rosemary.
I have a question from earlier. Someone asked, how did you get the courage to ask the next person?
I didn't. The next person asked me. The next time it happened to me wasn't me. I was never going to do it again. I did my scary thing. I never did it again. The next time it happened, I was 29. I was at a bar, and a woman came up to me and hit on me, and that was that. In fact, it was a while before I made the next move towards somebody. I was so scared.
I got a lot of comments here.
All right, let's hear it.
A lot of reaction, like, wow, oh my, wow. She walked away, her loss. Wasn't expecting that ending at all. Rhonda Ulster Brooks says, I don't know whether to cry or laugh.
Both.
Deborah Carito Natoli says, oh my God, I love this story. You are awesome.
Thank you.
Anna Coppola says, wow, just wow. Terry Wagner says, great storytelling. Thanks for the lunch diversion.
Thank you.
Kathy Beasley, I just adore you.
Thank you.
Rhonda Alsterbrook, maybe things really do happen for a reason. Kelly Richmond says, thank you for sharing. Allison Smith, thank you so much. You're so spot on and brave. Karen Shepherd makes me emotional. Met my now husband at 17. Gold.
Very cool.
Ethel Facto says, thank you for sharing. A lot of thank yous, clapping. Okay, here's some questions. Lisa Lucusi says, how did you tell your parents?
You haven't told them yet, have you? I haven't told them yet.
I think you and Steph are just roommates.
We found two kids. I'll come back to that one in a second.
Okay. Mary Allshouse says, you're amazing and I love your happy ending. Diane Bippert says, Janine has a bad connotation for me. 4 years of crazy with that one. LOL, nothing like that feeling though.
Isn't that funny?
Lorraine LaRussi says, almost the same story. Or Irussi.
Hold on, I have to take a picture with this mug real quick. Sorry.
Sure. Mary Solosis. Solis says, do you think rejection is harder to take in your newer world?
Look, rejection sucks. It doesn't get easier to be rejected. You just handle it differently, right? Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you react to it.
Anna Coppola says, well, I feel a little better about being 43 and finally finding my love. She's crazy, but I love her.
It's good. It's good. Crazy's good.
Diane Taylor said, what a great story.
Thank you.
Holly Magnanelli says, would love to privately talk to you about this.
Great. I'd love to answer any questions. It's important. So if you want to chat, email jennawolfshow@gmail.com. Or you know what? This is important enough. Email me at jennawolffitness@gmail.com.
Jennifer Kalenda says, thank you for sharing. Adore you, Jenna. And did you approach Steph first? A lot of people are asking how you and Steph met.
So Stephanie worked in London. She was in London for 10 years. And they, every once a year, they bring in the foreign correspondents into 30 Rock so they could base themselves out of New York, get to know the New York folk a little bit, re-sign contracts. So I know Stephanie, and I was training one of our producers, Madeline, and I used to train her at the gym. We have a gym at NBC, and I said to her, you're friends with Stephanie Gosk, aren't you? She's like, yeah. I'm like, I would love to have lunch with... No. I said, what are you doing today? She said, I'm having lunch with Stephanie Gosk. I'm like, I would love to have lunch with Stephanie Gosk. She goes, Stephanie's dating someone. I'm not introducing you to Stephanie Gosk. I'm like, hello. I'm dating someone too. Not interested in Stephanie Gosk. I just want to have lunch with her. Long story short, they meet for lunch. I've never in my life had a glass of wine at lunch. Not me. There were three or four people at the table. They all had a glass of wine. I'm not going to be like, I'm going to get a Diet Coke. A few cherries in it. So I had a glass of wine. Shouldn't have. They all had a second glass of wine. I'm like, all right, I'll have a second glass of wine. I have no business having two glasses of wine at lunch. None. But they were all done for the day. So afterwards, everyone like spread out, and I somehow decided to walk Stephanie back to her hotel. She was staying at a hotel there. And we started talking, and we just didn't even come up for air. We just kept talking and talking and talking. We spent like 3 hours talking. It was actually really great. And then we sort of stayed in touch. And over the next couple weeks, we both coincidentally broke up with the people we were dating, and slowly over the course of a few months, got together and then did long distance for 2 years. And then NBC moved her to New York, and that was it.
Okay. Claire Morris says, oh my God, it's so funny that you tell this. I'm about to jump into something very scary, and you just secured me in that I'm doing the right thing. You're inspiring. Keep being amazing, Jenna.
Thank you very much.
Eric Cole says, do you ever miss being with a man?
I mean, I love men. There's nothing against men. I feel like I connect more with women.
Joel Delgado says, we're super intrigued by you.
Thank you, Joel.
Lorraine Arusi says, I was 43 and finally happy, was married for 17 years, 2 kids, very unhappy now, I'm in love.
Okay.
I'm confused by that. Laura Ann said, I missed so much of this, so sorry if this is repeated. How hard was it to figure out coming out in the media? Was that an issue?
So the only reason I came out in the media, if you will, if that's a way to say it, is because Steph and I were expecting a baby. I was pregnant, and I knew that if I got pregnant and had, you know, grew over the course of 9 months on television without addressing it, there would be a lot of whispers, and is she pregnant, and there's no father, and who's the baby daddy, and what is she doing, and is she even dating anyone, and I thought she might be gay, and there were all these questions. And People Magazine approached us about telling our story to them in line with announcing it on TV, and I was 4 months pregnant, and I was soon going to either be, wow, Jenna's gaining weight, or Jenna's pregnant, and we needed to do something. So we decided to make an announcement, and coincided, like I said, with a People Magazine article that came out. And that is a story in and of itself, coming out on the Today Show that day. I mean, I had those nerves all over again. Because all my friends and my family knew, but the television audience didn't know. So I knew that I was going to have to go with the lump in the throat and the sweatiness and the palms. But I sat on a couch with Matt Lauer, and I'll tell that story one time too. It was a good story. Am I still on the Today Show? I'm not still on the Today Show. Sad to say. Sorry.
Tammy Hittman says, what a great story. Thank you for sharing something so personal but so helpful to many.
Thanks, Tammy.
Karen Scarotto says, are you still with Stephanie?
Oh, yes.
Kelly Williamson says, your transparency is beautiful.
Thank you.
And DJ Onyx says, two movies I love about meeting the right person at the wrong time. The first is Before Sunrise, and the second is It's Already Tomorrow in Hong Kong.
That's cool. I keep looking for this quote that I want to read you. Let me just see if I have it real quick. I keep trying to put in the first couple words and then I stop, but it's important to me. I want to just see if I can find it, and when I read it to you, you'll understand how I feel about meeting who we're supposed to meet. Are you okay if I do this real quick? I'm not ignoring anybody. I just love it so much. Is it here? No. Keep talking to me, Connor.
Sure.
Or keep reading comments. I'm going to find this quote. You're going to love it.
Kristen Mollick says, I remember that segment on the Today Show.
You could Google it. Google Jenna Wolf coming out.
Liza Collins says, awesome, Jenna. Your beauty and happiness radiate.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I feel like I'm getting closer to it. Oh, here it is. Yeah. You ready, Connor?
Yeah.
Great quote. It says, if you have chemistry, the only... Okay. If you have chemistry, you only need one other thing. Timing. But timing's a bitch. Right? Isn't that great? If you have chemistry, you only need one other thing. Timing. But timing's a bitch.
Interesting. Judy Hill says, I knew I was different since I was 7. So grateful now at 51. Our lifestyle is so much more accepted. Never thought I'd see that day that it's okay and
yeah.
accepted.
Cool. Love that. Good for you.
Lorraine Menendez says, Maria and I were friends, and 8 years later, we fell in love.
Jackie Jokeman said, oh, Sherry says, wow, Jackie Jokeman. I don't know what that's in reference to. I say this again. This is the best show. Thank you very much, Divine Girl. I'm buying Got Beat Up in School. I'm so sorry, Legends. That's so awful. That's awful.
Where was all this? Where?
I was living in Rochester, New York.
And you were on vacation where?
In Turks and Caicos. Have you and Steph ever had issues being gay with parents of kids' friends? No. JW by... Sorry, I missed that. Do you see the two? What are you doing there, Connor? I have to know.
I'm just doing my normal stuff.
I dated my husband in college. We married other people, divorced, and now.
Which one did you miss?
The last three on Periscope.
What did it start with?
JW.
Oh, it said JW... By you coming out, it gives guys like me not a chance in hell, haha. But love you still anyway.
Not true, you still have a chance. I mean, not really, but... Jackie Jokeman says, my aunt came out at age 77. Yeah, it is a shame she had to hide through her 60s. But good for her for coming out at all.
Alyssa Anderson says, when I saw your interview, it hit me like a ton of bricks that, oh my God, I'm gay too. Changed my life.
Good for you to acknowledge it, and I hope you were comfortable coming back out. Divine Girl says, do you ever go back to that resort in Turks? That Club Med is skews a little younger, but I have been back to Turks and Caicos. Marnie and I go, we still go away every single year. We still laugh about it. I got to get Marnie back on the show.
Christy Yeager says, love to hear about your leap of faith. Always think of you as fearless. And someone at, and Rhonda also broke. I'm sorry, she wanted to know if Facebook was blurry.
You missed how much I love your friend, except you discovered it. You missed how much I love your friend, except... Yes. Thank you. I wish Marnie was watching now. She's at lunch. Marnie has accepted me always, ever since high school, when I was literally the least attractive, most awkward kid in the world. Marnie said, I totally believe in you. I think you're going to be famous one day. I mean, how do you not love that kind of friend?
L Hedge says, Jenna, this is so important. Thank you for what you're doing. Would love to see more of it, more like this.
Thank you very much for saying that, guys.
Ashley Natasha says, you are so awesome. I'd like to do a fitness segment with you one day.
Okay, come on the show. We'll do it.
Emoji says, always love to hear about you and Steph.
Thanks. Connor was right.
And Lorraine Menendez says, woman like you will change the world.
Wow. All I'm trying to do is have a successful show that pays me so I can keep doing the show. But I'd love to change the world. That, too, is also up there.
It's a good second place.
Second place. Consul.
Okay. All right. We're caught up.
Wow. That was sort of exhausting a little bit.
I can imagine.
But in a good way. It took me two kids and a divorce before I could come out in my late 30s, said Mikkel Ovens, but good for you for doing it. My friends Richard and Sal both came out last year. I'm so happy for them. That's awesome. Legend Russell retweeted us. Thank you, Legend. Divine Girl says you are a strong woman, which is a great role model. Thank you so much. Hingson says my wife and I were friends 4 to 6 years. Timing changed. She left her husband and we've been together 4 to 7 years. Wow. Timing is a bitch. Dated my now hubby in college. Married others. Now together with 5 girls. Love it, Randy. Love it. Jackie Jokeman, Richard and Sal. Haha. Don't understand it. Someone said Jackie Jokeman is a stern troll. What does that mean?
He's not always a troll. I don't know.
No, he's not mean at all.
No. Ashley Natasha says, how do I go about getting on the show? Who do I contact?
You contact Connor, JennaWolfShow@gmail.com. And let's work out. Come up with a great idea. Legend Russell invited followers. Thank you, Legend. Love your show. What are you cooking today? So, C-Web, we're actually not cooking today. We were going to go outside, but I kind of like this conversation we're having and may not even want to go outside. I don't know. Parents should identify themselves before they have children. Says someone, Sherry, me too. I have the greatest wife. Legend is laughing. Jim Torres wants to know if I'm a lesbian. Mm. Kind of missed that story there, did you?
Yeah. Rhonda also books an awesome segment. Tracy Bender Schistler says you're amazing and such a strong person. Tracy Wright says, are you happy? That's all that matters.
I'm happy. I'm happy. Legend Russell has a TV show. Happy to promote a Legend TV show. Randy says, best show today. Randy! Mwah! Besos, besos, besos. Thank you for saying that. Much, much appreciated. If you are, my God, show mercy over your soul. Does that, may God show mercy over your soul? That means I'm doing a bad thing by being? Yeah, probably, right?
Yeah, I think.
I'm sorry, you think that's so horrible that I'm, it's not my fault. That's who I am, and I like it.
Christy.
Salut, je suis français. Ah, ben, salut. Sac E TV. This is my first time here. You're amazing, Jenna. Simply Cine. Thanks very much, Simply.
Christy Yeager says, does anything scare you now?
Oh, gosh, yes. Well, the obvious, swimming in the ocean at night, needles, and getting eaten by sharks. But also...
the obvious.
The obvious.
The things everyone's scared of.
Yeah. But also, que faites-vous? I'm doing a show right now, but... attendez un minute. Je vais expliquer quelque chose. I'm scared that I'm, you know, look, I'll be honest with you. Like, I'm worried that this isn't going to work out. Like, this, bills don't just get paid. And I love this platform and I want to do it forever. And we're trying to make it work. And if it works, amazing. And if it doesn't, that's mildly terrifying. I will have to find something that does. So that's terrifying. But millions and millions of Americans go through that too. You know? That's scary to me. That's what scares me. Ooh, I must have set my own.
Deborah.
I'd love to tweet about this, and I caught the end of your show, says Ricky Blaze. Can you tell me who that was? Legend says you're bilingual. Je parle français, oui, un petit peu français, parce que j'habite en Haïti. How do you and Steph feel about marriage? We hope nice. Are you from Jamaica? Yes, I was born in Jamaica, Kingston, Jamaica, and I was raised in Haiti. You are lucky you weren't born 30 years earlier. I love when I was born, where I was born, and how I was born.
Selena Marie says, God loves everyone. I hate when people say that stuff.
I know.
Deborah Gaskell says, I've always been out, but my wife came out when she met me 12 years ago. It is women like you that gave her the courage. I'm out of the country on business watching you from Leuven, Belgium.
Wow. Very cool.
You are refreshing to watch.
Divine says, can we assume you don't swim in the ocean in Turks and Caicos at night? Thank you very much. That is really pleasant to say. And no, I do not swim in the ocean anywhere at night. Nicole and I, that is part of life, says Nikki Blazer. Very cool. I'm noob in English. Newbie?
Yeah. All right. We're caught up everywhere. Lisa says, how long have you and Steph been together?
Oh, look at Michelle Melnick is saying, watching your show in London. We love you. Aw, thanks. Shout out to Michelle Melnick. Love Michelle Melnick. You guys, everyone follow Michelle Melnick on... Michelle, what should they follow you on? Twitter? Facebook? Michelle is one of, like, 27 sisters, and they're all doctors. And Michelle is one of Stephanie's producers at NBC Nightly News. And one advantage to not being on the Today Show is not having to be up so early. Yeah, you could say that. There are some disadvantages. That is one of the advantages. What was your question, Connor?
Someone asked, how long have you and Stephanie together?
Stephanie and I are together 5 years now. Michelle, are you single? Because we have a lot of amazing guys on this show that would love to go out with you. You guys, I want everyone. Michelle, just tell me if you're single before I move forward with this. Michelle Melnick is one of the smartest people I know. She's hilarious. She'll like wake up at 7 and be like, what should I do today? I'm just gonna run a marathon. But first let me get a bagel and a cookie. And then she'll run a marathon and be like, I think I want soup. And then she'll like come home and like watch 14 movies. She does whatever she wants, but she's so smart, she can do it.
Does she have a job?
Yeah, she works for Nightly New. Does she have a job? It's very funny.
Okay. You know what's funny is like, you watch Friends, do they have jobs? Like they say they have jobs in Friends.
Yeah.
They don't, and Seinfeld, well, I guess they do have jobs.
Yeah, they have jobs.
Friends, they don't have jobs.
Well, what's his name? It was a paleontologist. Ross was a paleontologist.
Yeah, but they never go to their job.
No, not during the
They're
day.
They're always...
Well, Chandler Bing went to his job every day.
Sometimes.
But only sometimes. I wish I could help you. I don't know what to say.
Isella Al says, my break is over. Bye, Jenna.
Too bad.
All
right. Haha, you're up. Yes, I'm single. All right, Michelle. Michelle Mellon, look her up. Yeah, Monica was a chef, Randy. Brian is from Scotland. Hi, Brian. Nikki says, I have a family member who married this girl and it was the best. Of course it's the best. How cool is it?
Okay.
Oh, I feel so relieved having said all that.
Good.
Really good. Hello, Jenna and Connor. Sherry says hi to us every 20 minutes, like to wake us up, and I love it. Love it. Lisa Dover retweeted us. Thank you, Lisa. I'm a director and I own my own show, says Legend Russell. Very cool. I am not a director, but I guess I kind of own my own show.
Laura Ann says, how do you make money with a show in this format? What can be done as viewers?
So that's a really good question, and thank you. We have our boy Lance, our partner here. He's out trying to get sponsors for the show. I'm not sure what the answer is.
What can people do as viewers?
Well, they could retweet us. Just get the word out there.
Or this is on Facebook, but for, yeah.
Paris. Or repost it, or just talk about it, or tune in, or invite followers, or like it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Viewers is probably the best way to help us.
Yeah, the more viewers we get.
Yeah.
Perfect.
More viewers we get, the longer we stay on air.
Brian said, I missed the story. What was it? It was a long, long story. You might want to just rewatch the segment. You don't want me to tell it again. Let me start from the beginning. Oh, look, people are doing it. That's really nice. Divine invited followers and Bird52 invited followers. Randy said, rewatch it. Cool, Brian's going to do it. Thank you, Brian. Then let me know what you have to say. I'm going to be coming out on a documentary this summer. Very cool, Legend. We'll try to catch it and watch it.
Lakendra Foster said, how is that helping us?
How's what helping us?
I don't know. Like them sharing or...
It's not. It's helping us. But I'd like to think in some way I'm helping you if you have a question.
But also, if you're watching and you enjoy it, then it's helping you to keep watching.
Yes. Have you ever been invited to sit on The View or any of those other Yenta shows? I have not. I was on, Meredith's show, and I'm on Dr. Oz, but I never did The View.
Coral Leather says, I've been wishing this segment into being for a while, but now I have to go to soccer practice because my team is in the cup final on Sunday.
Awesome. Good for you. Good luck. Let us know how you do.
Lorraine Menendez says, my only regret is that I came out so late. I would have loved to have children with my wife. Too old now, LOL. 51. I came out at 42.
Congratulations. Whenever you do it is when you do it. Jackie Jopin thinks I'd be really funny with Kelly Ripa. I think that'd be amazing. But she doesn't, or they don't want to have me as a possible guest host.
Claire Morris says, what's your favorite vacation that you and Stephanie have taken the girls to?
We haven't taken the girls on many vacations, but Stephanie and I went and hiked the Dolomites in Italy. right before Harper was born. That was amazing. Amazing. But still, Caribbean is usually my best vacation.
Cool.
Where are we on hearts, Connor?
We passed the 4 million mark.
Yeah, but someone said 5 million.
When? Yesterday?
I guess.
I mean, I think they're saying we're gunning for it.
Oh.
But we're not even close.
Okay.
We got about 900,000 more to go.
Cool.
This segment might have helped us.
Legend Russell said, I should come on his show. I'll become famous. Okay. I would love to. Thank you very much for the offer.
How Nice says, did you have a religious upbringing? And if so, what was it like in Jamaica and Haiti?
I was Jewish. There weren't many of us in Jamaica and Haiti, but my dad and mom did their best to make sure that we were, you know, surrounded by a safe and beautiful Jewish home. Ever consider doing scopes from popular spots in New York City? Yeah, we should. We should go do some Periscopes and some Twitters and Facebooks from different places in New York City.
Yeah. Gassia says, were you out to your family and friends before you came out public on television?
Yes, I was.
Alright, caught up.
Yeah? There is a way to get followers. Be on other people's media. YouTubers do it all the time. Thanks, Ren Bear, Ren Bean. I don't know anything about that.
That's Renee.
Oh, Renee.
She hasn't been around for a couple days, but I think. Brittany writes, "Is how did your parents take it?"
So my parents, I'll just go ahead.
And what advice to those parents who feel like they failed as a parent?
My parents walked in on me with that girl that I passed on the street. That's how they found out.
Oh, really?
Yes. It was in the city, and they, like, blah-bitty-blah-bitty-blah-bitty, just walked in, and la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Like Kramer style?
Yada-yada-yada. What?
Like Kramer style? Like
sort of.
Burst in the door?
The music was on. They had the key. They were dropping off some winter clothes. Anyway, it's so dramatic to me that I have to, like, move past it. Then they went home, and my best friend Matt came over, and he was like, just call him up and just say it and do it. I'll hold your hand. And I, like, held his hand, and I called him up. I was like, guys, this is it. Here is me. This is who I am. If you have any questions, now's the time to ask. I'm not apologizing. I'm not making excuses. I'm not lying. I'm not going to answer all these questions in a million years, so just ask him now and get it out in the open. My mom was like, love you no matter what, no matter what happens, we love you. I was like, what do you mean no matter what happens? Like, nothing's gonna happen. Like, what do you mean? We love you. I think she was reading, like, from a Hallmark card. She's like, no matter what happens, we love you. Like, we love you no matter what. No matter what happens. Like, she was just like, I think my dad, like, finally hit her and was like, stop saying that same thing. My dad didn't say much. I think they were just, like, shell-shocked.
Yeah.
Both parents, she was shell-shocked. I was like, how did you not see it? But they didn't see it. And I said, great, I'm glad we had this talk, even though I did all the talking. And that was it. Took them a while to, like, fully wrap their head around it. I'm
trying to find relevant comments. There's
what are the comments about?
Bill O'Reilly.
Well, we can talk about Bill O'Reilly if you want.
Want to? Okay. The comment was from Stacy Bufkin, says, what are your thoughts about Bill O'Reilly after working in the news industry? Do you feel women are at a unique vulnerability in this industry?
Look, it happens. It used to happen a lot more. A lot of men feel entitled and feel like they're in a position of power and thus feel like they are immune to being punished in any way, or that women, or especially, like, women coming up through the ranks, producers, interns, are indebted to them and they can have their way with them. It's a terrible balance of power in the industry. It doesn't happen all the time or everywhere, but I absolutely have seen it, continue to see it. I think we are slowly moving past it as women are more comfortable in speaking up and opening up to tell their stories.
Amanda Hall says, I miss you on the Today Show. I hope we get to see you again on another TV network. You are on my wish to meet list.
Well, come to New York and come meet me. Right now, this is it. My mother used to hate gays, but now she's okay with it. Good legend.
Coral Leather said, my mom said, I guess Coral Leather is from your mom. As long as it's not an incurable disease, it'll be okay.
That's true.
Kagan says, do you think Billy Bush should be given a second chance? Since we're opening the floor to...
Yes. Do I think he should or do I think he will?
Should.
I think he should be given another chance. Yes. And I think he will. I was trying to read Red Beans Renee's comment, but I missed it.
Let me see if I can get it. That was Sherry talking to Ren.
Oh, okay.
Renee said, coming out to my parents took 16 years.
Wow. Why don't you take over O'Reilly's time slot on Fox? So RTP Associates, it doesn't really work that way. I won't be able to call up Fox and say, hey, what's up, it's Jenna. I'm just gonna take over his spot real quick. You guys cool with that? It just doesn't work that way. But thank you for the offer, it'd be fun.
Brenda Bryan says, what are you up to these days?
This is it. This is what I'm up to these days. I started this daily talk show on multiple platforms. There's like 5 platforms here. You guys can't really see. If you go on my Twitter account, there's a picture of all the different places. We're on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Sportscaster, Periscope. We do it every day. We'll see if it works. I can be myself, I can talk, I can interview people, work out, we could go take a walk, we can do a whole host of things, we can cook, and I can tell you really intimate stories and answer a number of questions and be as honest as possible.
Okay. Teresa Fernandez says, I missed the main live video. Can we rewatch it after this?
Can they?
Yes.
How?
Just head over to the same page you're on, the Jenna Wolf page, or if you're on Periscope, just head over to broadcast. If you're on Facebook, head over to videos, and you'll be able to find it in the library.
Or Twitter, you'll retweet it, right?
It'll be on Twitter as well. Yeah, it is on Twitter.
Randy wants us to head out on the road like 2 days a week. The truth, Randy, is I got a little lazy today. But you're right. USA Today.
You can also watch in HD on YouTube.
Yeah.
At the Jenna Wolf Show.
That would be cool.
Yeah.
All right. What do you think? That was a lot.
That was a lot.
Who do you think is calling? Do you think I should just answer it?
Yeah. Only one way to find out.
Hello. From Apple support, we noticed there's been some shadiness happening on your iCloud account. We just want to make sure you're okay, so please call us and give us your username and password and we'll fix it for you. Look, it's a learning experience. You're supposed to hang up, because I called Apple and I said, hi, I'm returning your call, and they said, we will never, ever, ever call you as far as and on behalf of customer support and tell you that that's happening, ever. We'll never do it. So if you get a call like that, hang up. When you say coming out, what do you mean? Jay Smash, what do you think I mean? Like, out.
All right.
You should give it to them. I think it's legit.
Instagram just went down.
Oh, because we were on for an hour?
Yeah, but...
All right. I wasn't aware of that scam. It's terrible, Divine Girl. Don't ever, ever, ever do it. Someone in Russian said, Privyet. Thank you. Would you ever have Erica Hill on the show? Of course. I should call Erica. You like girls? I do. Lisa Dover says, block the number. I should. Sherry Stretch says, hi, Patty. Patty Hamilton. Hi, everyone. Looks great today. Thank you, Patty. Jenna needs a bottle of wine now. I need 2. Jay Smash says, no more men? No more men. And Morris says, yeah, I had to jump from Instagram to Periscope. Okay. McMissy retweeted us on Twitter. Expert Mailman says, I like horses. All has to do with everything.
Have you seen the I Like Turtles video?
Nope.
Oh, I gotta show you that. Stanley Levels said, were you fired from NBC or did you quit and did you have a no-compete clause?
I mean, I wasn't fired. I walked away, but I probably would not have walked away as soon. But they wanted to change my role up a bit and I guess reduce it a little bit. But I could have stayed in a reduced role, and I didn't want to. I had too many things that I wanted to do. But it is what it is. And what was the second part of the question?
Did you have a no-compete clause?
No, I did not. I could do whatever I want.
Okay. Do you want me to get back up on Instagram, or are we going to...
No, we'll take a break.
Okay.
How long have you been a woman? What? I've been a woman my whole life. I was so disappointed when you left NBC. I was a little bit too. They did the same thing to Tamron. Sort of. Basically. I don't know. Randy's laughing right now. How does a non-compete work? NBC sucks anyway. Says Randy. What did you come out of? Just a closet. How's Lance doing? I don't know. He doesn't really call anymore. But hopefully he's doing okay. Yeah, all right, so we're going to take a quick break, and we'll come back right after this.
Okay.